Good afternoon and welcome to another episode of Let's Tackle Code Wars. Today we're going to be looking at formatting a number as a price. Today our objective is to add formatting to a plain number and display it as a price. Function should return a string. Okay, it looks like we're given a very long decimal and we need to turn it into a readable number. Numbers should use standard comma for every three numbers and dot to separate the cents. Cents need to be truncated to two decimals, and so that in the case that the decimal part of the number is one character long or none, you should add zeros, so then the result will always have two decimal characters. Okay. Should return a string, not a number, if the input is not a valid number. All right. Let's see what we're getting presented with. Alright, console dot. Oh, let's start with some pseudocode. So, given a number, turn number into a string. Does the number include, or does the string include a decimal? Alright, remove all spaces, two spaces after. Two indices after the decimal, then length of string before decimal. If length greater than 3, comma to add a comma to a string to 3, and then repeat until no more commas needed. All right, console.log number. Okay, we're given 1500 and .129. All right, so let's take a look here. Let's do toString. Helps me. All right, and so so let's take care of that comma or the decimal part first. So what I want to do is const decimal index equals number dot index of let's see if we got that right. Okay, cool. 0, 1, 2, 3. Yep. Awesome. And now we have to remove everything afterwards. So I'm thinking Slice? I think Slice returns. Splice, then, I suppose. Let's take a look at the what Splice uses. Array.splice. Start delete count. Cool. For one element index 4, so April 0, 1, 2. Wait, what? Index. Hold on. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. What? Inserts index 1. I forgot to look at this one. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So start at index 4. So we're going to want index of plus 2. And then remove delete count. How do you get delete the rest of it? If delete count is omitted from the start. Okay, cool. Add to the array beginning from start. Okay. So this is items to include. We don't want to include anything, so we just use that. And number equal. Wait, does it return a new array or? In place existing elements. Okay, so we don't need to do number equals, we just do number dot splice, and we will do decimal index plus 2. Now let's console.log number. Awesome, so that got rid of our extra decimals. Now the fun part of adding 3. So how do we do it to where I don't want to get rid of this array, so actually, what we can do is we can get rid of this now. I want to keep this. So how I want to look at the array up to the decimal without modifying the original array. So I would do, let's create a new array. new. I think that's it. Awesome. So I believe we can use slice to get a new array into a new array object selected from start to end. Start end. So zero ending at before. Which to end extraction. Okay, so here's what I can do. I can do equal number dot slice zero small index. Excellent. So now, if the array dot length greater than 3, what if I don't want to delete something? If I just want to add. Zero. Okay, so I just put a delete count of 0 then. Yeah. No array dot length 0. We want array 1, so our index of 1 right here. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 minus 3, 1, 2. Okay, yeah, that would do it. Yes, that does a trick. Actually, no, it doesn't. Great. That actually puts me in a pickle because I need to append all of the elements. So I shouldn't have done this. Oh yeah, I shouldn't have done that at all. All right. How am I going to add that comma in there? Let's take a look what we've got. Excellent. So I need to what I want to do is I want to look at all of the indexes up to the decimal. And starting from there, I could do a loop. Equals decimal index. This greater than equal to 1. Next minus minus. So, okay, 0. All right. My thought process is if count reaches 3, then splice to add a comma at the in at the index of
index.
If count equals 3, number dot splice. Index delete count 0, and then add a comma, and then count equals 0. Oh, count equals 0. Let's see how this goes. Excellent. Unexpected identifier. think my cat just sneezed. That was an odd noise. Okay. Let's try removing this. Yeah, I didn't like that. And count plus plus. There we go. That worked. Oh my, that worked. I'm pretty happy about that. And then what? Number dot join negative 5. Oh. Ooh. Yikes. Oh, I think that, yeah. So I need I'm drawing a blank here. I want to say it's number dot join. Yeah, number dot join. Negative 5, what? Oh, because we're on another number. Got it. This is where the part where this, if it doesn't have any decimals, then add 2 zeros. So is this is a real dirty way of putting it, but oh, what I could do is oh, okay. What? It worked before. Expected. Oh, so I actually got the commas to work properly. I need to add a second zero. How do I add that second zero? That's for your question. I could turn it into an array again, or let's take a look here. Oh, and then the next one is not a number. Cool. How do I get it to look at that string? My instinct is if there is nothing after right here. Actually, yeah, if the length after it is less than 2, then add a 0. If number dot let's see what decimal check brings us. That's interesting. Oh, I should probably do this afterwards. Still does it. Oh. Actually, now I'm confused. Decimal index plus 3. What does this do? Okay, let's back it up a bit because I'm getting a little lost in my own writing. Let's go back to before decimal check existed. This was fine. Ah, okay. So it's just removing the extra decimal spaces. Now I remember. Okay, cool. So this means after Spice 00. Let's make some comments for my own sanity. Okay, so we can get rid of this. Decimal check equals number dot slice decimal index. Take decimal and now, oops. Decimal check. If this decimal check dot length is less than 3. wasn't checking for that. Expected at 0.002. Cool. Is integer. Return not a number. What? What do you mean if it's... What? I'm guessing so because it has a decimal, it's not going to return true. Is numeric. Would that be false? Guessing that's some French thing or don't listen to regex. Regex is icky for this. Okay. I just want to check if it's a decimal. Ah, oh, float, yeah. It should be a fairly simple I suppose. That should do it. Check if it's an integer by flooring it whether or not it's a decimal. That should do the trick. Expect a not a number to equal not a number. Are you kidding me? Yeah, looking at this, there's probably a significantly easier way to do this. Why am I struggling so hard with this not a number thing? What did I delete? Oh, that's probably what I deleted. Sorry about that. Just trying to clean this up a bit, you know. Where is it? 46. Okay. I'm guessing I was really overthinking that. What? Why didn't that? What? I don't understand. Why wasn't it returning? I. What am I. I was asking if. Okay. Math.floor number equals not a number. Why is not a number not equaling not number? Because not a number does not equal not a number, I suppose. Oh, Boy, that's interesting. Think this is where I need a is integer. Was it number dot is integer? Oh, let's try this out real quick. Is integer, not a number. Should return false, right? Yeah. Let's try that. True. All right, that's what we like to see. So then math.floor, if number is integer, math.floor number. Equals false, then it should return not a number. Expect not a number to equal not a number in a string. Are you kidding me? Slightly upset about that, but okay. I wasted way too much time on that. Yeah, this is definitely not the most optimized solution because we've got 20 lines here. I'm guessing someone made one that looks like 5, but it works. So what we're doing is we check if it's a number. If it's not, then return not a number as a string, and then you do number.toString.split to turn it into an array, and we find the index of the decimal, and then we remove all extra decimal spaces from the array. Now we're actually checking to see if it has one. Or decimal check, or yeah, decimal check equals, yeah. And if it has less than, if it doesn't have two numbers after the decimal, then add some zeros. And then it adds a comma for every 3 numbers before the decimal. Turn it all back. It combines all of them back into a string. If there is no decimal, add a decimal and 2 zeros, and then return the number. I mean, this could honestly be anywhere. I mean, yeah, it doesn't really make sense to have it up there, I suppose. I'm just going to leave it as is because it's going to get confusing real quick if I do that. Ooh, what did I do? Oh boy. It was working fine before. Oh boy, what did I get myself into? Expected negative 200 minutes. Greater than or equal to 1. Yeah, it should be working. Well, we basically solved it. Now I just have to go back and debug whatever small change I made to screw this up. So while I was formatting number as a price, thank you for watching. I'm going to try and figure out where I screwed this up at.